Jehovah is the center of excellency of oil and the gas, the only one in Africa.
Possessing international qualifications is one of the key requirements for getting employed in the oil and gas sector because they are the only qualifications recognized by international companies. The issuing of certificates to vocational institutions comes days after President Museveni and a team from Tanzania appended signatures on the final oil pipeline project agreement.
Thank you, our chief guest.
State Minister for Higher Education John Chrysostom Muyingo says accredited institutes can now skill students in upstream and downstream petroleum studies, welding, electrical maintenance, and metal fabrication, among others.
What learners with the skills that will market them all over the world, enable them to acquire jobs from all over the world, compete, out-compete other people all over the world, but also enable us attract students from elsewhere who need similar skills, which will bring in quite a lot of money as well. They may come as tourists to come and see what is happening. There will also be quite a number of students who would want to do the same course.
The minister also toured Nakawa Vocational Institute. It is from this background that he expressed a need for government to inject more funds into research and innovation. Muyingo further officiated the opening ceremony of a second national agro-skill competition for technical and vocational institutions in agro-processing and post-harvest management. The State Minister for Labour, Sam Engola, is convinced that such competitions will help deal with the challenge of unemployment.
You cannot work just as quickly as you are thinking, but slowly by slowly, it will reduce because people will have what to do here in the country. Though people are free, one is free to do what? To go out and work. But it should be procedural. When they are going, we have to induct them how they are going to stay there, how they can go, how they can handle this system there. And we should be linked with the Ministry of Labour.
In the same line, organizations in the oil and gas sector have appealed to government to be considerate to Ugandans when giving jobs in the oil and gas sector, ensuring transparency and protect the environment, but most importantly, compensate people who are likely to be affected by the petroleum project.
Challenge the oil companies, the government, to go and investigate how many people of those that have been compensated have managed to replace the land that they have lost. When you go down from our studies, we find that very few, if at all, of the communities that have already been compensated are able to replace the land that they have lost.
Story by Juliet Namoya for the news.